this many people here today. Thank you for coming. All right, now this one is, it's not on your data sheet. We're gonna generate our own data for this one. Aha. All right, find it though.
Don't need that, I do need this.
Oh, you can't see that. All right, I'm gonna share something that you guys saw in, 243, if you had me for 243. This is a bit dated, and there's a reason it's a bit dated and I want to use it. So there was a campaign back in 2004-05 called Granville Report a Gem. It was an online campaign. You guys saw some of these in 243. It was a fun little campaign called, I think it was called Meet the World, I believe is what it was called. Yep, Meet the World. And what they did was they took the flag of a certain country and then showed you statistics slash parameters from that country through the colors on the flag. Let me show you some different ones before I look at the U.S. Let me go online and find them for you real quick. So the ones you guys looked at in 243 were, they revolved around, there we go, there's a few of them. Let's pull some up here. So here's the one of the ones you guys saw in 243. Kind of hard to see. This is the Brazilian flag, kinda. There's a little bit of a banner missing across, the Portuguese banner. And if you look at the colors on the flag, correspond to...
That's crazy.
It is kinda. It's crazy and powerful.
Yeah.
So the green area represents the proportion of the Brazilian populace that live on less than $10 a month. So what would you say, percentage-wise, what's that green? 85, 75, somewhere between like 70 and 80%, 85%. The yellow proportion lives with fewer than $100 a month. Blue, fewer than $1,000, and the white lives with more than $100,000 a month. So just by looking at the colors of the flag, you get an idea of what?
Economics,
how poor the country is on average.
They're all important issues to the country though, right?
Say that again?
It's not just... Like, this one's poor in the United States with the war. It's all, like, important stuff.
So Rory's saying what they did, this is what I like about what they did, they found parameters that matched the proportions. There are others, obviously, right? I mean, God knows Brazil has loads of issues with government corruption. That isn't measured here. Well, maybe it is. Could be. But I'm not saying that's not... So let's back up again. Let's look at... Which one's this? This is not big enough to see. Yes, hang on. Oh, maintenance mode. I don't want that. Is that Colombia?
Must be.
Did you click visit?
It's got coffee, cocaine, and banana. Yeah.
Yes, banana, coffee, cocaine. I'm gonna guess that's Colombia.
Yeah.
So throw that out there. So again, half the country, half the exports of cocaine, the other split between banana and coffee. It's not. It's not necessarily so many bananas, just the percentage of those exported. Yes, that's the idea. It goes back to the question Chris just raised. It could be one banana, one thing of coffee, and 2 kilos of coke.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, that's, how are you measuring it, just as a percentage? Okay. Is that fair, Chris?
Yep.
Here's Turkey, I believe. Is this Turkey? Angola, not even close. Jesus. Hang on. View image. Why am I? Oh, there we go.
Yeah, that's a machete.
That's a gnarly flag.
People infected by HIV, people infected with malaria, people with access to medical care. So again, one of those things. And we're not talking about, this isn't a pie chart where you're seeing one characteristic broken into sections. You're looking at disparate things. So roughly what they're saying is roughly 45% of the population is affected by HIV. Roughly 45% is also infected by malaria. That could be the same person, right? That'd be awful. And then roughly, what's yellow? I mean, right? What's yellow? What percentage is yellow?
People who can actually get help.
But I mean, what number would that be? Ish? 15? 10?
Yeah.
10%? Yeah. I mean, that's, you know,
so
1 in 10.
That's not supposed to represent 100% of people.
No. It's not. it's not like, here's a pie chart of all the diseases in Angola. This chunk is HIV, this chunk is malaria. Yeah. We're looking at, there's other diseases that aren't represented on there, like typhoid.
Like there's somebody that doesn't have malaria, doesn't have HIV, and doesn't have access.
Correct. Or somebody that doesn't, and does. Yeah. I mean, you're looking at three switches, all of which are thrown on right now. There's also other combinations of those switches. Is that fair?
Yeah.
But again, even though that's not entirely the best, it's still amazing to look at that and go, holy crap. Let me find, there was a few more. I didn't show you guys these in 243. Where was the other one? China, I did show you. What's this one?
What was the US's?
Just we're going to go back to that one, because that's what I'm going to collect data on, is the US one. Okay.
There's one that should all
Afghanistan. Burkina Faso.
What?
Burkina Faso.
Oh.
Children who die before completing 1 year of age. This is depressing as hell.
Yeah,
die before their third birthday. Now, the first thing I thought was, this can't be numerically true. Because I thought, this is 50% and this is 50%. That means everybody dies before they're three. Half the population dies before they're one. The other half dies before they're three. But it's not half. It's like 47% and 47%. Which means, if this is true, only 3% of the population is maturing. That I find hard to believe. Or I find that to be such a sad state of that country. Chris, what are you going to say? You're
going to
say or.
No.
You sure?
Where is this?
Burkina Faso. I don't know where the hell that is. I have no idea where Burkina Faso is.
That's what
Yeah, maybe that's what I don't know about.
Yeah, that's their insertion.
Hang on.
Yeah, tough shape because nobody knows what the hell
it is. It's got to be.
Promises no. Military promises transition. Where the hell is this?
West Africa.
Next to Naimi and Benin. Landlocked country in West Africa. There we go.
Probably got, Ebola too.
Oh, there it is right there. Holy God. So in other words, it's got a 97% mortality rate. Now, that blows my mind just thinking about that. Hurts my head.
It's amazing it's still a country.
Well, right. Wow. Let's look at one more here. Here's the list of all the flags. And I encourage you guys to check this out. It's really, really disturbing and also very... What's this? Blue? Is this...
What flag is that?
We'll find out. So women who
Africa.
Endure genital mutilation, women who do not. Boy. I don't know what flag that is. Now, this one would be a pie chart. An awful, awful pie chart, because it's either a yes or a no.
Yeah.
90% yes, 10% no. So, again. So, anyway, that's making me depressed. Let's turn that off.
What does it mean when the flag has fringe?
I don't think that means anything. I don't think. I don't think, anyway. So here's one of my favorites. Can you read the legend? Okay. This is about 2005. Red area, in favor of the war in Iraq. White area, against the war in Iraq. Blue area, can't find Iraq on a map. United States. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, United States. So what would you approximate the blue area is?
That's a lot of people.
The red is smaller than the white.
Remember, not a pie chart. Just because you're against the war in Iraq doesn't mean you can find it.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying it's not in proportion.
The red and the white?
The red and the white are supposed to be the same size.
Don't forget the white
right.
stars.
Yeah.
I'm just talking about the stripes.
No. I'm saying if you add up all the areas, I've done this just because I'm a dork. I'm geometric. I'm a dork. I calculated the area of the blue, and I had to calculate all of these stars first. And if you add up all the white stars, it essentially adds up to a white stripe. I see what you're saying. We're slightly more against than for. I guess is what you're saying, right, Chris? Except that you have one fewer white stripe.
Are you saying that they messed with the flag?
No. I'm saying that there's a balanced opposition to the war versus those who voted equally against it. It was showing the dichotomy of the war's effect on the country. Combined with the fact that what percent can't find Iraq?
10, 15.
It's almost exactly 20. It's 19.7%. It's 20%. I calculated it out using the congressional. Because I'm a geek, I figured it out. 19.7%. Okay, you guys ready to collect some new data?
Okay,
you ready? Put your phones down. Phone's over. Nobody's using their phones. Find Iraq.
Got it.
Okay, don't tell anybody. Don't tell. Find Iraq. Don't say it out loud, though.
Did I get a margin of error, like one country?
We're going to make a margin of error. No, you don't, Chris.
Good question.
No margin of error for you. What's up for you? All right. Ah, come up and point to it.
No,
where is it, Bren?
You're wrong.
No, I think you're right.
If I'm wrong, don't make fun of me.
Yep, there.
There it is. Let's collect data. Be honest. Okay, who found it? Be honest.
1, 2, 3, 4. Close.
Close.
No margin! I couldn't. Today I knew where it was because I paid attention to it, but before the war in Iraq, I could not find it. I'm going to go ahead. What? You have to go to work. You didn't find any of this. We got 4 nopes, 12 found it.
Oh, I wasn't nope.
Oh, wait. So, nopes. Raise your hand if you couldn't find it. I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Ratios 8 to 12. Couldn't find it. My hypothesis is that since we are no longer at war with Iraq, Americans stopped paying attention to where these countries are. Burkina Faso, perfect example, right? Why don't you know where Burkina Faso is? You've never heard it in the news. You have no reason to go look for it. Well, now we know where it is. Now we know where it is, Western Africa. But until 10 minutes ago, you never knew where Burkina Faso was because you've never heard about it because it never made it to the news. We pay attention to the countries that impact us. When Russia invades Georgia, you figure out where Georgia is. You're like, wait, what's Russia doing in the deep south? No, not that Georgia, the other one. sweet God, Americans. So how y'all doing? God.
This just makes me want to say, I can't believe how many people still don't know Washington, D.C.
From Washington State. And it's funny because being an East Coaster, being so close to D.C., it's like, it's one of the first things I learned. But I did not learn that the Redskins are from D.C. I didn't know that until relatively recently. I felt kind of embarrassed to know that, or not know that.